Oh, he's potted it. Can you believe it? Well, surprised you didn't spot that, Peter.
I'm sorry, yeah. Didn't see that one coming, Dennis.
But a bonus to fluke it. One of the best flukes you could wish to see.
That helps. What a lovely little fluke and a beautiful little kiss on the brow. Barry's not too impressed. Oh, that'll help.
He needs the green, does Ryan Day.
Holds his hand up and apologises, but I suppose the run of the ball was just favouring Ryan slightly, but this shot here has changed all that. What a fluke.
Yeah, what was that, the snooker gods? As I said, and this is... if it's not bad enough, one's flicking reds.
One.
All right, he's not in a colour, he's not going to score off it. But if he can nestle in behind this yellow, this could be big trouble the way the reds are.
Couldn't refuse it, but he wasn't looking for an arc on the cue ball, and he's had a right result there. If he doesn't catch the brown full ball, he's on nothing. Just trying to arc it, but it arced too late. But the kiss on the brown leaves him nicely on the red.
Oh, that'll do. I can see that one, John. Call yourself one. An analyst. Ah, I can see it now, John.
Has to get this very thin. He's playing it, the cue ball back up the table. Yeah, the double kick always looked on, but boy, oh boy, he's been fortunate. No wonder he's laughing.
Yeah, once he'd got one of what Dennis calls the DDK, the dreaded double kiss, how's he found the gap? There's always a gap.
If he's playing the white up and down here, the double kiss looks very close. No, I managed to avoid it. No, he's not flicked one, has he? Surely not.
One.
Well, as if things are gone. Bad enough for Michael Field. That's two balls he's after fluking in these opening exchanges.
Yeah, here it is again. Full ball in the second red and then dead weight. As Ken said, it happened in the last frame and he got a half ball kiss to land on the green, similar this time in the brown.
Plenty to put the cue ball, obviously, on the cushion. Milkins doesn't need. He's fluked it. Nice start.
One. It's funny, you knew it was in halfway across that.
Yeah, it could even come off two cushions and leave the cue ball below this red, near the left corner pocket. Lots of check side, doesn't want to hit the knuckle in the middle pocket. Nice, flip to red.
21.
Worth another look at this. It turned out to be a trick shot.
Well, what a fluke.
He's fluked it. What a fluke.
One.
That's a monster. He's got to make this count now. Really stick the knife in.
You never really know where they're going to finish, but have a look at this. Have a look at this for a result. Wow. He is snookered. He just hit it hard and hoped for the best. Why did he get the best?
Push a red towards the left corner. Well, that was a fine shot.
Yeah. Hit two reds to get back down to where he's finished, which is very unusual. Thin on both.
A doubly fine shot.
Yeah, have a look. Thin. Look at his reaction.
Can't believe you didn't see that one.
Well,
one.
What can you say about that?
It's unprintable. Never ceases to amaze you, this game, does it? In the end, Stuart thought, well, I can't see a safety. I'll push the ball out and try and pop my way out of trouble.
Oh, he might hit it. What about this for a hit?
Everybody's smiling. How many cushions did he hit there? I've lost count.
Yeah, just the five.
Happens. Let's count the cushions here because I wasn't sure. There's one, two, three cushions. Misses the yellow. Four cushions. Five cushions. And that got everyone smiling.
It was good fun, wasn't it? It was a bit like that game they played in continental Europe, wasn't it? Carom. The three cushion billiards or three cushion cannons, whatever you want to call it.
Well, if he's on the pink, he's been very, very fortunate. One.
Yeah, and that was an example there. If we watch that pot again, look at the unintentional side he had on the cue ball. I mean, he was playing it plain ball and he had a load of right-hand side on it. Lucky to get the pot. Well, finishing on the pink, it's not fair sometimes.
Should be okay. Well, he's going for the screw back. This is dangerous. This is very dangerous.
Well,
one.
I didn't see the double on.
Excuse me. Yeah.
Left an easy one for Barry Hawkins. Just have a look at this again. If this red doesn't go in, it's wobbling and staying there.
He's been knocking these in the last couple of days. No. But crunch time arrives. Has he flipped it? He has. Wow.
Seven.
Ooh. What difference is that going to make in the final outcome?
I always think you're more chance of missing it when you put a safety element into it. It's not far away.
Well.
Green's just in an awkward spot to get up the table as we show you the pot that was a long way off, but it wasn't a long way off that pocket.
Well, this is another difficult shot he's trying here. Tried to power the red.
12.
Didn't spot that one.
Yeah. Look where the cue ball's finished. Right, now which red's he going to pot here? Answers on a postcard. Here it comes. Yeah, what happened next?
It's tough.
He's gone for the double. He's got
treble.
Is it a treble?
No.
Oh. Oh. Well, he took the double on because the black was safe and he finished up with a treble. What a bit of good fortune that is.
Side on the cue ball, straighten it up. Now he's got to hit it and get it safe. Where is it? It may go close. Oh.
Yeah. Wow.
referee. Okay.
He's not on the brown as he would have liked, but there are signs that this match is turning into John Higgins's favour.
Is it in? Is it in? Wow. What a hesitant technique. A real spot black. Even Key Walton leaves the arena smiling.
Well, the middle pocket got in the way of him playing the shot that he intended. And, well, he'll be delighted to see that disappear in the middle pocket.
Very unusual type of style with the underarm from Mark Williams. And hold on. The pick may go in, yeah. Hold on, hold on. Hey! And he's going to have a go with the black. And why not? We want to see a bit of entertainment.
Well, he does have a nickname, Ball Run Bingham.
Six.
His fellow pros seem to think he does a lot of this.
Seven.
And if he was to win the frame this visit, that will hurt Jack Lazowski.
And why not? And how's your luck, Joe? How's your luck, Joe? Unbelievable. Nudge there.
Settle down, please.
It was a good pot, but why? Have a look at this white. The double kiss across the table.
Stop it.
Would you believe it? Shades of Cliff Thorburn, who made the first ever maximum here. He fluked a red that ran along the cushion.
Hello? 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 Hello?
That has brought smiles all around at the Crucible.
What a trick shot that was. It's only going to get him 5 points, but have a look at this one. He overcut it, and everybody thought, oh, he's missed the blue, but, well, he'd got other ideas. I'll just play a little trick shot.
Did you not see that one, Dennis?
Matt Williams special.
Just typical Mark Williams.
Well, that is one way to test your cue action.
This might be one who might not even look at the cue ball when he hits this. There you go. Oh.
No. No, you're kidding me. See, that's a secret, Dennis. Don't look at what you're doing. Is this the winner of the World Championship we're looking at here?
I don't think I've ever seen someone pot a ball without looking at it. Well, without looking at the cue ball.
No. No. You're kidding me.
I've seen it, but I don't believe it.
I don't know why he was amazing shot. It was the biggest fluke you'll ever see in your life. There's nothing good about that. It was just total luck. If you think I played that, then I'm not even answering one more question you got for me.